Hey y'all, Mary Kennedy here from Kennedy Fan 5, and let's look at transformations. So I have seven little mini assessments. They're all made on Google Forms. They're, I believe all of them are five questions because 99% of mine are five question mini assessments. The first one is transformations vocabulary. This one I have the symbol, and I'm pretty sure I used the symbol from the Equatio extension, but you know, you can make that on your keyboard. I have a video, I'll put it up here somewhere so you can see that, because it's really like short and simple and just easy to do. So here's just other vocabulary, making sure they know y equals x and y equals negative x. And this one is actually just check boxes. So they have a lot of choices. So I'll show you how that looks. Here we go. There's the check boxes. And so the answers are scrambled too. And it just says select all that apply. You could be specific and say select three right answers or however many are correct. And you can always delete those options too, you know, so you can go in here and just hit any of these little X's and just completely remove that option. And let's look at translations. So here are writing a rule, choose two correct statements. They need to know the word isometric. And because it's just typed in there, if you buy mine, you can rewrite it and use your own whatever wording that your kids are used to or that you're using from your standards. Black and red image here, I was real specific in the, you know, trying to say pre-image to image, because lots of times kids do the opposite, you know, and so they're going to go up instead of down or whatever. Okay. I wanted to point out here that I think those graphs are really small, and obviously you can hit the control plus and you can make it bigger, you know, I mean, you know that, or control minus to make it smaller, but I wasn't trying to be super tricky with this. So if you notice that, you know, it's saying go right five. And so if you go right five, you're going to end up at 0.13. And so when you look at the four choices, I mean, there's only one that puts it over at 1.3. This one's at 1.4. This is at 0.3. So it's got to be this option two. And other than that, you know, it's pretty straightforward. And same idea here, you know, that I wanted to make sure they know which quadrant it's going to end up in, but not trying to just like be super tedious about it or anything. This one's rotations about the origin. And so sometimes it's just from a coordinate point. Sometimes it's looking at a graph. Same with the graph here. You know, if they're in the right coordinate, then they're going to see their answer very plainly. And they don't have to see all of the little bits and pieces of it. If they know that this is going clockwise right here, then clockwise means, you know, it's going to turn to this third coordinate. And there's only one option that's in the third coordinate. Okay. Write a rule from a graph of a pre-image and an image, and then one more where they graph. And again, not too picky about that. And write another rule from coordinate points. So this is what it looks like on Teachers Pay Teachers. This is the whole bundle of all seven assessments. I'll put the link to this in the description. Okay, so reflections. Let's take a look at this. So here you're seeing a reflection. You have to choose the correct rule. Same thing on this one. Here they have to graph. And again, they can make it bigger if they need to see it. But really and truly, you know, it's pretty much, you know, you're going reflecting across the x-axis. So they should know it needs to be in quadrant four. Write a rule. They have to find the coordinates after a reflection. So for just a segment. So that's, yeah, a little bit different. All right, mixed practice. So this just kind of puts them all together. This is a lot more difficult because you know, if you're in the translation section on like homework or something like that, like, you know, oh, it's just sliding. But here it could be a reflection. You have to look at more than just a couple of points and that kind of thing. So I tried to make the answer choices really more challenging to really assess, do they understand what's going on here? Here it could just be a slide left and up from the pre-image to the image. Also, they have to really pay attention to E and E prime and know which is the pre-image and which is the image. So the notation's important. Here they have to state a rule. Same thing here. And here's the graph, and this one is rotating 90 counterclockwise. So they have to, you know, understand the counterclockwise rotation and know which quadrant they're going to end up in. All right, dilations. So here we have a little grid almost. I think this is called a multiple choice grid, is the way, the one that you would choose if you're making your own. Here they have to state coordinates for a dilation of 0.25. Of course, you could write 1/4 if you tend to put your dilations in fraction form. Here it's saying state the rule, and then the last one here, and then perimeter and area after dilation. The circumference is this, was the circumference after dilation by scale factor 1/4. Here they have to choose two answers. So I put it beside the answer choices, choose two answers, even though it's written up here, two correct answers. I just want to remind them. So if they think it's this one and this one, they'll be able to select both of those. Got the upload your work button. Anytime that there is work to be shown, I try to add that button in so that it's there for you when you're in the actual form itself from the from your side of it, the teacher side. You can always just hit the trash can. It'll be in this area when you click on it, and you can just take it out completely if that's not what works for your classroom. And then here's another one with two correct answers. And this one, I like, it works backwards. It's saying the perimeter of the image after it's been dilated is this. What was the perimeter of the pre-image? So that's a good little challenging question, I think. All right. So I think that covers it. I hope that that's helpful to you. I hope that having the unit all in one place is helpful to you. And I hope you have a great day.